So, what kind of world do the man and the boy live in?
It's an undefined time after an apocalyptic circumstance.
So, you'd classify it as
a nuclear winter. It doesn't clearly state it in the story, but it's very clear that it's been a long time after this apocalyptic event has happened.
Each day is more gray than the one before. It is cold, and growing colder, with the world slowly.
So explain how the circumstances of the man and the boy at the beginning of the story affect the meaning of the book.
At the beginning of the story, both the males are very displaced. They have no place to go, they have no place where they can call home. The boy hasn't even really ever had a home. They're trying to find the promised land at the south coast. But unfortunately, even when they find their place, there is no place there.
You go south.
Oh.
You keep them warm and you go south. We won't survive another winter here.
I'm hungry.
I know. So am I.
And we're still heading south?
Of course.
There might be food there.
Everything depends on reaching the coast. Okay?
Gotcha. So, the two are pretty isolated from the rest of the world.
Yeah, and I think McCarthy is trying to say that when you're isolated, you die because the man, he tries to keep the family isolated. He kills everyone and threatens the boy, and they run away from anyone who's ever threatening, even though they might not be. And at the end, he dies. But the boy, he finds someone, and he is the one who lives on in the story to carry the torch sooner. Because the man, he was always isolated, and he was trying to keep everything isolated, and he wasn't strong enough to carry everything through. He had no help from any others, and he tried to keep everything that way. The fate for him is that he died, but the boy, he found someone and he was saved.
So how does the boy progress throughout the story?
The boy was very innocent at the beginning of the story. He never asked any questions. Whatever his father told him, he did, and he never questioned it. However, throughout the story, he began asking more questions. Why is this that way? Why are things this way? And he becomes from an innocent boy to a very knowledgeable young man. And this is kind of leading to the allegory of the cave, because at the beginning, the boy is more like the prisoners in the cave, you know, who only know what the pictures are on the other side of the cave. However, he sees the light at the end, and he knows what's on the other side, and he doesn't want to go back to just being in the cave.
Where's that man you're with? Is he your father?
Yes. He was my papa.
I think maybe you should come with me.
of the good guys?
Yeah, I'm one of the good guys. Why don't you put that pistol away?
I'm not supposed to let anyone take it from me, no matter what.
I don't want your pistol, I just don't want you pointing at me. So you got two choices here. You can stay here with your papa, or you can go with me. If you stay here, you need to keep off the road.
How do I know you're one of the good guys?
You don't. You'll just have to take a shot.
Do you have any kids?
Yes, we do.
Do you have a little boy?
We have a little boy and a little girl.
How old is he?
About your age, a little older.
You didn't eat them?
No.
So, you don't eat people?
No, we don't eat people.
And are you carrying the fire?
My what?
Carrying the fire.
You're kind of weirded out, aren't you, kid?
Well, are you?
Yeah, I'm carrying the fire.
I can come with you?
Yes, you can.
So what's your take on the landscapes painted by McCarthy?
McCarthy used the landscape to not only set the stage of this post-apocalyptic world, but uses the relics of the old world to draw the attention of the reader to the fact that this novel is McCarthy's brutal depiction of the world.
How do you interpret the trout in the pond at the end of the novel?
McCarthy beautifully describes the trout to relate it to the man's dreams of hope in the boy. The trout is hope in humanity brought upon by the boy, and the pond is the newly restored world.
So what's the relationship between the boy, the man, and their journey?
It is the man's duty to lead the boy down the journey of enlightenment. The man must show the boy that within himself he will find the golden chalice, the final hope of humanity.
We have to talk. That man back there, there's not many good guys left, that's all. Watch out for the bad guys. You have to just keep carrying the fire.
What fire?
Fire inside you.
Are we still the good guys?
Yes, we're still the good guys. Of course we are.
And we always will be, no matter what happens.
Always will be.
Should the reader look for a cave allegory in the road?
The reader should find evidence in the road that supports the idea of a man and a boy's journey as a quest for the Holy Grail, or as McCarthy writes in page 64, the Golden Chalice. I don't subscribe to the connection between Plato's allegory of the cave and the road.
Kinds of things into it. Some people say it's about the journey of man on earth, it's about a man's, you know, spiritual journey here on earth. Is that true, or is it just about the man and the boy on the road?
I like to think it's just about the boy and the man on the road, but obviously you can draw, you know, conclusions about all sorts of things from reading the book, depending on your taste. It's a pretty simple, straightforward story, I think.
Throw these connections to Plato's allegory of the cave throughout the book. Even on the first page it reads, "In the dream from which he'd wakened, he had wandered in a cave where the child led him by the hand, their light playing over the wet, low stone walls like a pilgrim in a fable swallowed up and lost among the inward parts of some gigantic beast." At this point, we understand that they're in the metaphorical cave, but at stage B, which is freed from their shackles. The allegory of the cave is also present in the father's early strife to relentlessly look backward in the rearview mirror, which offers an altered vision, a mirrored image of reality, which corresponds more to stage A, which is illusion. The road they're traveling on represents the path out of the cave, calling it the road instead of a road or this road, mythologizes the road and gives it its uniqueness. It's out of the ordinary. And it also symbolizes the journey undertaken by the father and the son. Their journey out of the cave, or on the road, is their path of enlightenment. It is portrayed as an expedition out of the dark into the light, or out of the land of despair. During the course of the road, the characters never fully reach enlightenment, as shown metaphorically by the fact that the sun never emerges. However, the hope that one day it will emerge is explicitly implied. Paul Friedlander wrote in his book, Plato, an Introduction, that the journey of the cave always requires guidance. And I think that's really what this book is about. It's really more about the boy's path to enlightenment while the man is there to provide guidance for him.
If you flicked your tongue like a chameleon, you could whip the food off your plate without using your hands. But what would your mother say? If you craned your neck like a crane, you'd have to stretch your arm way up to scratch your head.
Hang at me. I'll take care of you. I'll kill anyone who touches you. Because that's my job.
Every day is a lie. but I'm slowly dying. That is not a lie. I'm trying to prepare him for the day when I'm gone.
The father is limited in teaching the child by his holding on to the past and ideas of how the world was and therefore should be. The boy realizes that living in this world is more about accepting survival, is more than about accepting survival, and that's just the first step. To truly educate the boy, the man must elevate him and guide him to maturity. The boy finally begins to surpass his father when it becomes obvious that he has outshined him in terms of philosophical advancement. After the man and son disagree about the man's treatment of the thief, where he forces him to give him everything he has, as well as remove his clothes, the boy realizes that it's not only necessary to be freed from the shackles, but to survive, and it is indispensable to survive the right way and not fall alongside with the bad guys, which, according to the boy, the father has by causing the thief's death.
Would you stop sulking? He's gone.
He's not gone.
What do you want me to do?
Just help him, Papa. Just help him. He's just hungry. He's gonna die.
He's gonna die anyway.
I'm so scared.
I'm scared. You understand? I'm scared. You're not the one who has to worry about everything. What? What'd you say?
Yes, I am! I am the one! Okay?
The father fails to lead the boy completely out of the cave, but he helps him on his way to enlightenment. The boy sees his dad as a role model for better or worse, and by the end of the book, understands the need to see the sun and search for enlightenment himself.